Kadex recently released a series of gimbals for their FPV cameras, which is an interesting option for fixed-wing aircraft. In this video, I will present one of them in the 3-axis version and show you how to prepare it for operation. The series includes 3 versions of the gimbal: single, dual and 3-axis. We have the 3-axis version, which is the most commonly chosen option, stabilized and controlled in the pitch, roll and yaw axis. Let's unbox it and check what's in the box. Inside, apart from the gimbal itself, there are no additional accessories, except for the signal cables. However, you can buy it in various packages, including cameras and VTXs. The product page link is in the video description. Here we have the version with just the gimbal, and we will connect it with a VTX and a camera in V2 version, which I've used before. All gimbals are only compatible with the VTX V2 versions with 1 or 2 antennas, as well as with the Moonlight. However, gimbals for FPV cameras are not new to the market, as such equipment has been available before. The new feature in these gimbals is the ability to control them via UART directly and wirelessly through WalkSnake goggles. Previously, gimbal control was only possible through PWM, so the gimbal had to be connected to a flight controller or a receiver with PWM outputs. You could also connect an external head tracker that sent signals to the receiver via a wired connection to the transmitter, or control it with knobs or sliders on the transmitter. This option is still available, but you can also bypass it and control it directly from WalkSnake goggles without additional wires, using only RX and TX wires between the VTX and the gimbal. We have 2 cables included in the set, one with just the power, RX and TX wires, and the other with additional PWM wires. However, at the moment, the only goggles that support this are the latest and cheapest WalkSnake goggles, called Goggles L. There's also a video on the Kadex channel showing the configuration of this gimbal with the Moonlight kit and these goggles. As you can see, everything works independently without needing to use the RC link. According to Kadex, a module will be released in the future to enable head tracking for the Goggles X. We know that they have built-in gyroscopes, but it seems an additional board is needed, which wasn't planned during the Goggles X launch. I don't currently own any of this, as I'm still using the first version of WalkSnake goggles, and I'm satisfied with them. However, I won't have the chance to test the head tracking at this time, so we'll use PWM control. Let's prepare this set for operation. First, you need to use a small screwdriver to unscrew the camera cover. Inside, disconnect the coaxial cable connector. I always try to do such tasks with a soft wooden toothpick to avoid damaging anything. Next, take the camera and plug the coaxial cable connector into the gimbal. The camera needs to be screwed to the back of the gimbal housing. The next step is to connect the gimbal to the VTX with the coaxial cable, which is done in a similar manner. You need to remove the USB cable because this connector is needed to connect the VTX to the gimbal. And that's all the wiring. As you can see, we have a lot of PWM wires to prepare for connecting to the flight controller. Before connecting it, we'll mount it to the aircraft. I designed a simple mount for the hatch on our Stallion airplane. There's potential for mounting the camera on the nose or in the bay under the fuselage, but I chose the simplest option for now and we'll mount it to the top. The gimbal is mounted with 4 M2 screws on well-insulated rubber pads. We temporarily detach the antenna to mount it in the shown way. The VTX is normally mounted with 4 screws spaced 25 by 25 mm. Now, we just need to connect the antenna and the remaining wires. During power up, note that the voltage range is from 7 to 26 volts, so you can connect it directly to the battery or to an appropriate output on the flight controller. However, you can't connect it to the standard servo outputs, as they usually supply 5 volts, unless they're set to a higher voltage. Everything is ready. Let's see how it looks on the aircraft. After connecting, the gimbal immediately stabilizes and enters 3-axis follow mode. I like this, for fixed-wing flying is a good choice. However, there are two other modes available where pitch and roll keep level, yaw axis follows, and pitch axis keeps level, roll and yaw axis follow. You can also adjust the sensitivity of axis tracking. I also used pan tilt control, but not with a head tracker. Instead, directly from the transmitter using sliders. On the left side, I have vertical movement, and on the right, horizontal movement. This set is now ready for flight. Soon, I will test how it performs, and in the next video, I will show you footage from the air. I will also share the modified hatch for the Stallion with the presented mount. See you soon.